Raymer Stockman is cautious by necessity.
I haven't got the balance.
At 79, she's thinking ahead carefully before each step and relying on help.
Thanks, Graham.
From Graham, next door, and from her walker.
So I can't walk anywhere without it.
Getting about on her own isn't as easy as it used to be.
You're right, you're going to make it.
Graham's been helping her find a better option to stay mobile.
Got the wheelchair, so if I need it, but then I need somebody to push it.
Raymer's quest for independence leads her to a website advertising powered wheelchairs.
We thought we'd found a good electric wheelchair with a 30-day return option.
There it is, in the banner. 30-day money back. With confidence, Raymer clicks buy, pays $1,400 and waits.
So you'll have to open that.
This isn't one of those fair go stories where the thing you paid for never shows up.
Don't spray it all over me, will you?
Ironically, it's not about how hard it is to open the box either.
Come on.
But like sparkling grape juice, once you've let the genie out of the bottle, it's hard to get it back in.
Getting it out of the box was it like two bags of cement plus another half bag on top.
It wasn't the right thing for me. It's too big, too heavy, too everything.
Now, to be clear, the weight is listed on the website in very small print at the bottom. It arrives as described, though a wheelchair labelled Team Lift that clocks in at 43 kilos might be stretching the description lightweight.
It's very lightweight. Okay, it's more Weet-Bix required.
It isn't faulty. As far as Raymer knows, she's just changed her mind, but...
You could only return it if you hadn't opened the box.
Eh? It's not a packet of chips, it's a wheelchair.
If you haven't opened the box, how do you see what you've got?
The trouble is, it's all in the fine print too.
Oh, that's... No, that's not it. Yeah.
If you dig down into the warranty policy, there's a bit on the change of mind policy, a long list of conditions, including that no opening the box rule. If you've just changed your mind about a purchase, the seller can set their own rules. They don't have to refund you. Raymer hadn't seen that list of conditions, though. She feels Best Deals is being a bit tricky.
Absolutely wouldn't have bought it because I need to see what I'm buying.
And when she gets in touch, Best Deals wants to see too. They wanted to send photos, so she's had to open the box anyway. The company makes this helpful suggestion.
That I sell it to a relative or a friend. I don't have any relatives or friends who need electric wheelchairs.
We want to ask Best Deals, is this for real? This isn't toothpaste in a tube, or a toothbrush in a plastic cube. It's not a mandarin in its peel, or a pair of pantyhose sold with a seal. This is a $1,400 powered wheelchair shipped in a carton, sold online. So why say no return if you open it, and then change your mind?
Oh, unreasonable, totally.
We want to be as helpful as possible. Since we're driving back to Auckland, why not drop by the place where this bothersome box began its journey to Raymer? It's not that easy. Best Deals doesn't have a New Zealand office. It doesn't have its own warehouse. And the people on the phone say no, they can't accept a return.
Especially now that this has reached the media, we are afraid that a lot more of our customers whose claims were also declined will demand for their claims to be accepted too.
Which makes me wonder how many others are being caught out by opening the box and losing that 30-day money-back cover. While this is all legal, it's pretty tricky, so we persist and manage to track down one of the owners of Best Deals, somewhere in Australia.
So what's the point of having a 30-day money-back but saying it's no good if you've opened the box?
It's still can return it, but it's not the original price because we still need to do some work on the return item.
Right, is she going to get her money back though?
I can say we're definitely a fair people, so if you give us enough time, we can definitely do some real things for you, yeah.
And once I get this back to the depot the company uses here, Best Deals does have a better deal for Raymer than a flat no. A refund of $1,380. That's minus a restocking fee of $20. They mention that fee on the website. It really pays to read the fine print before you click buy.
Now, Raymer, very happy with that, because after all, the fine print said the restocking fee could have been 20%, which would have cost her $280.
So $20, great result.